This is my favorite research site at the Harvard Forest. So right now, Greta and Kate are measuring this tree. They're doing this thousands of times all summer. And what is it?
It's 60.2. And what was it last?
Yeah, what was it 10 years ago?
55.3, so it's grown. That's impressive.
This tree has grown almost 5 centimeters in the past 10 years. And that's where the carbon's going. Good job, Red Oak. The lifer plot is very cool because it goes all the way back to 1969, but we have a lot of data starting at the time of the LTR around 1990. And so we realized that we had 25 years of data to put together. And so we decided that we were going to do that and ask some very simple questions about, how much carbon is at the Harvard Forest? How is it distributed above and below ground? How has it changed over 25 years? The resulting paper involved a couple dozen authors from more than 10 institutions, and it took us a few years to finish it. We had all of these different long-term plots. We had controls that are part of experiments. We had 3 eddy flux towers, and there were really important messages and findings coming from each of those.
The basic measurement that we're doing is the carbon dioxide flux. You need a sensor that measures the concentration of CO2 in the atmosphere. In our case, it's measured 4 times a second, and then you simultaneously have a wind sensor that's up on the top of the tower that measures the vertical and horizontal fluctuations in the wind speed. So wind's not just moving along like a sheet. You can visualize it kind of like a river, that there's little swirls in it, and those are what we call eddies. The thing that eddy flux gives us that you can't get any other way is it gives you really an hourly measurement, is the really kind of useful scale of what the plants are doing. So you can look at ecosystem scale responses to temperature and light variations, or what different patches of the forest. So if the wind is coming from a stand that has a lot of hemlocks, you're seeing what the hemlock's doing. If it's coming from the oak forest, you're getting that. So you're getting a kind of picture on a kind of interesting time scale that tells you about how does a whole ecosystem respond to those environmental drivers. And the other thing that's really key about making these measurements long term is we're trying to understand how at the ecosystem scale the landscape will respond to the changing climate.
We found that over the last 25 years, the Harvard Forest is a very consistent carbon sink. That total amount of carbon is split up pretty evenly between, above ground, so the tree trunks, kind of the lasting things, the tree trunks and the downwood, split between those elements and then the roots and carbon in the soil. So I think what that says is that, forests' potential to mitigate climate change, at least in this region, is a really strong prospect. They coming back every 10 years and visiting those trees over and over again. I don't really think the trees care, but we do, and feel like it's in a way curating a part of the forest, at, just as a librarian would curate a collection of books, and really trying to come back every decade and checking in on how the trees are doing and how much they're growing. And we can do a lot of cool quantitative things with that information, but I also think that it's just an act of witnessing.